seen all season long in the Parker NZ V8 touring cars. There has been carnage aplenty. One guy who's desperate to stay out of it. Look for the red and white car there on that seventh spot on the grid, Wade Henshaw. The thing he has to do is stay out of trouble. He's got Angus Fogg in front of him. He'll let him go, I swear. He'll let just about everybody go who wants to fight with him, I would think. Just wants to be careful he doesn't get caught up in any trouble.
Well, the hearts will be in the mouth. The adrenaline will be flowing. These guys will be looking for that green light. Look at this, Kane Scott just keeping the pace very slow, and they're off.
So let's see who's got the fastest, the most wick as they come down to the turn. Well, it's Kane Scott out dragging Andy Booth. Of course, he had the advantage of being the man who dictated when to gun it. Oh, big carnage. Oh, straight into the barriers and through the smoke. We can't see who's there. I think that's Andrew Fawcett's car is one of them. It's gone. Shane Drake, I believe, his car is totally smacked up there. This is going to be a race stoppage for sure. I think Shane Drake has gone through. I was wrong about that. Let's see Paul Pedersen in the Haviland car. That is severely smacked up in the rear end. That is the car of Cameron McLean, the 40 car. There's Dean McMillan's car stuck there. Lots of guys just slowing down to go through there. Cam Hardy is caught up in it. Mike Pirro, the series sponsor. Nick Ross's car is the one that's really taken, the Porter Hire car, that's taken a huge hit. Several hit big hits. Good to see he's okay. That's him out in the black and white suit there.
Well, it's almost a reenactment of the race last year. Similar thing happened. Obviously not quite as bad. There's probably about six or seven cars tied up in this. So as we can see, the race has been stopped.
Well, it happens all the time, doesn't it? It's a sad thing, but I mean, when you get a field of 36 very evenly matched cars, or most of them very evenly matched, that someone having a bit of a sit down there, because that's Nick Ross. Look, he really has taken several big hits, and you can see the guy's pretty shaky. Let's look for the replay. On board with Shane Drake coming down the inside. Ooh, that is Cameron McLean moving over on Andrew Fawcett. That's looked like what started it. Now, Shane Drake is... did get straight through there. I thought he was actually caught up in it, but it was Nick Ross's car that was dinged up. Here we go again. Look at this.
All it takes is one touch, as you can see, straight across the field. Three, four, five, six cars. And of course, the guys behind him has got nowhere to go. And hey, you know, visibility's gone. It's just a mess.
It just carried on for such a long time. You could see Paul Pedersen's car, the Caltex Haviland car. Here we go again. Look at this view. This is what Andy Booth throwing the challenge down to Kane Scott. It doesn't work. Now wait for it. Here we go. It's already happening. They carry on over the fence. Oh. The Marshals, they were very lucky. It's good to see that they got away okay.
Well, I see Nick Ross before sitting on the track. I mean, taking an impact like that really just takes the wind out of you. And lucky there's not more serious injury there.